I can change the world with my own two hands, make it a better place with my own two hands, make it a kinder place.
I was actually offered the job at the right time in my life. I had done art in the studio for a number of years and really also felt the urge to get out of the studio and bring my art experiences outward. And I started doing a lot of teaching and traveling as a visiting artist. And I traveled, did projects from California and Utah and then up and down the East Coast for 14 years. The one that I like to talk about is one that right here in Philadelphia, a block away from Independence Hall. It was a project through the Mural Arts Program, and I had painted it with a friend and colleague of mine, Paul Santillari. This we did in 2003, the summer of 2003, right before I had started teaching here at LaSalle. The mural is a 50-foot long, 3-foot high fresco mural that's embedded in the side of a building in a niche. It took us 3 years in the planning of the project, including getting all the funding, and then it took us about 8 days to actually paint it on site. And the one thing I like about this is also a picture of my wife and him right after at the hospital, and she was holding him after giving him birth. But that's what made it a personal art project in a way, even though it was a public art mural. I was able to put something of my life in that.
I've been in the LaSalle art program since sophomore year, and I really enjoy it. And now I'm in painting, which is definitely the toughest one, but I really enjoy it.
We're free to do what we want, like artistically.
I mean, I think it's a really good creative outlet, like any artistic thing, like music, you know, because there are no rules in art, so you really have the freedom to do whatever you want. You can take any kind of artistic license you want, you know, like you make your own rules in art, and you create whatever you want. You know, Mr. Hearn doesn't make you do anything that you don't want to do or anything you don't like to do. So there's a million ways to show yourself through your art, you know.
What inspires me, usually it can be anything actually, whether it's an interesting scene or object that I just happen to come across. Usually though, my inspiration is through what I'm interested in at the time, whether it's like a certain like film or a different type of music or an artist that I've just been studying for a while in terms of style. It's actually interesting to look back on like my sketchbooks because they're mostly made up of portraits of what I was interested in at the time, and sort of like it's like a time capsule. So. My past and my future depends. I did of a music festival that happened in 1967 called Monterey Pop. And it was like the first major festival for music, and I guess I just tried to capture that with some of the popular figures in the festival and actual designs that were inspired by like seeing some of the artwork that was actually present at the festival. So, and this, you know, this is music that had a real big impact on me at a young age, so I think I captured how important it is to me in this piece. Drew a couple pictures and I painted them tie-dye, dedicate them all to the beauty of your blue sky. Which way do you fold your crane? Does it cry like the rain on my window pane? How does it sing and what does it say? Does it shine like the gold of my lion's mane?
It's easier to draw in your agenda book with teachers around.
Pretty much all my drawings are Wiz Khalifa.
There's this real popular show called The Office, and there was a phase where I was really into that this past summer, and I did some characters with pen and ink. Well, the rivers are different, but the water is the same. Yeah, yeah. Which way do you fold your origami crane? Which way, yeah, which way, 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 which way.
which way?
Boom. Get at me.